Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Caught us by surprise here. Welcome to a new episode of The Garage. And today, as you can see, our workspace is empty. And this means two things. First off, you're in for a surprise. And second, I'm in for a surprise also. All I know is that we have a fantastic guest with us here today. He's an expert from Continental, and he works for the Research and Development Department responsible for material evaluation. And, by the way, he's also a professor at the university in Hanover. So please welcome Mr. Jorge Lacayo. Jorge, nice to have you with us today.
Nice to be here.
How are you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Maybe you can explain it to us. What does a compound of a tire consist of?
A rubber compound mainly consists of elastomers, nanofillers, additives, curative system. They are polymer chains.
Mm-hmm. Sounds great, but can you keep it simple? Can you explain it to someone like me?
Oh, yes. Let's do some magic.
Hey, Jorge, what did you do?
Well, we did some magic just to help you.
This looks like a little trattoria here.
In this case, polymer chains and macromolecules are just like spaghetti. These polymer chains, they are basic element in a rubber compound. They are the macromolecules, and they are independent from each other. Mm-hmm. So then we do some mixing. We need some additives. We need, for instance, some softeners. This could be the sauce. Oh, please, Chris, not a ready sauce. We just use at Continental fresh ingredients.
Should I start cutting some herbs?
Yes, please. That would be probably some anti-aging. We also use oils in the rubber technology. We call them softeners too. We also need vulcanization agents. And we use fillers in rubber technology. We call them active fillers because they reinforce the mechanical properties of the rubber. We do now some processing. After that, you get a very homogeneous rubber compound.
Now that looks good. This looks ready to eat. This is
yes.
A perfect
for
meal.
Us would be okay. We'll be ready, but the stiffness is not okay.
But I like it like that, al dente.
But you're not a tire. We need some stiffness, and that is just like when the spaghetti left there for a while, they become sticky. You know that from home.
Yeah, when I come home late from work,
yes,
for example.
Then they are sticky, and the polymer chains are attached together by a crosslink. And we call this process in rubber technology vulcanization.
So I guess all that gives us a perfect tire?
Yes, this is the perfect compound for the perfect tire.
But how do you know that it's perfect?
Well, we have to test it. Mm-hmm. We test it in our labs. Would you like to do that now?
I would like to.
All right.
Ready?
Enjoy.
All right. Buon appetit. Now, it's not only perfectly explained by you, Jorge, but you are also a very good cook. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
There's one more thing I would like to do now, and that is to take a picture.
Smile. Ding. All right.
Now we got another great photo for the album. I had another great guest here with me today, and I hope you tune in again next time for The Garage. Jorge, I'd like to thank you very much for your time, for the cooking, for the ingredients, and for the magic you brought to the show. Thank you very
much.
My pleasure. See you again next time. Bye-bye.